Good morning. Hi, kids. Heidi here. So it's Monday morning. Sky is blue. The sun is out. And the mailman will be here in about 2 hours. And I haven't done any of my shipping for the weekend because I saved it to share with you. Usually, I'll package things up 3 or 4 times over the weekend so that I don't have a big bunch. And then I just know it's done, and I know I have the item. I found it, but I saved it for you for a ship with me video today. I have my thank you stickers. I have some Poshmark envelopes and my eBay envelopes. So let me tell you, overview. Wow, crappy weekend. 14 total sales. A normal weekend before summer was 15 to 20, 25, 14 was disappointing, but here's what's weird. 5 were on eBay and 9 were on Poshmark. Total sales for the item itself on eBay for 5 items, $89. $17.80 average. That's pretty bad. 9 Poshmark sales for $242. $26.88 average sale price. So my total sales for the weekend, probably Friday noon, were $331. And my net profit, net after costs, platform fees, and cost of goods, $211. So I guess if I'd gone out and worked retail somewhere and worked really hard and got tired and dirty, I probably couldn't have made $211. So yay, happy. Let's see what we've got, okay? I will put pictures in. That's what this big blank space is for. Because as you know, my items are already packaged up and ready to be shipped because I store most of my items in the garage in plastic bins with lids, but I also want them to be protected and folded and everything else. And this was in bin X, and this is the inventory number that was on it. So let's find that item, shall we? And then I'll tell you about it. And we'll see how much money we made on it. I'm so disorganized. I wish I could be McThriftsy. Oh, there it is. So, this is a Victoria's Secret bra. And it had a zipper in the front. Oh, so crinkly. Does that bother you? Hope not. Let's have a sip of coffee. Victoria's Secret bra with a zipper in the front. I feel like it was called something special. And this is on eBay. So we'll put it there. I bought this 2 months ago. And I don't know why I don't have my cost written down. Sorry. I sold it for $16.02. So after all the fees and costs, $11.47 was my net profit. I think I got this at the bins because I don't normally look at bras. It's hard to look at bras and I don't often, couldn't find my stickers. I don't often find anything good. So I go by the bras to see if there's any new tag things hanging down. And if something catches my eye, I'll look. But I don't go through every single one. But at the bins, everything just comes up in front of you, right? Where am I going to put these? Okay. I don't have a trash can. I'm not prepared. I just feel so disorganized this morning. Do you care? You don't care. Get on with it. So because my sales were so crappy this weekend, yesterday, noonish, I marked down all my swim 20%. I didn't do a sale. I did a bulk edit of the price, 20% off. That's cool because you can choose items either in eBay store categories or your own store categories or just one at a time, pick things off your active listings and then go into bulk edit and change something about them all at the same time. And when you do prices, you can raise or lower the price by a percent or a dollar amount. So I selected on my swim in men's and women's, and I said, lower the price by 20%. Click, click, done. So handy. And then if I ever want to raise it back, I can do that. Very similar action. Get on with the shipping. $55.96. Oh, you have to be so careful with Prana. So here's some Prana pants. I've had them a month. Paid $375. That's not bad. Some Prana will get, Prana is becoming for me a marginal bread and butter. Rarely I'll get something that's $35, $40. But most of it is $15 to $25. If you disagree or tell me what I'm doing wrong, please put that in the comments. Because I like Prana. I think it's pretty good quality. It seems to always sell. It just doesn't get what I want for it, if you know what I mean. So, am I buying the wrong stuff? Am I pricing it too low? Because some items, if I price them where I want them to be, they just sit forever. So what did I do these? I sold them for $16.91. My net after fees and costs, $7.44. That is only bread. There's no butter on that. But they're gone. Happy hiking. What's next? Ooh, these are heavy. I sure hope I'm doing the right thing here with labels. What are these? These are Madewell jeans. Road Tripper. High-rise Road Tripper. I'll put a picture up in a description. I've had these for a month. I got them at Salvation Army. And so I probably paid about $5. I sold them for $34. So after fees and costs, my net profit was $22.71. I like that very much. What do you think? Do you like that? Everybody says Madewell jeans, you have to be careful. I think that $34 for a pair of used jeans is a good price. For me, probably a good price for them too, but it's what I was looking for. What I'm always hoping for when I get jeans, because I don't find mother and goldie. But Madewell is still exciting to me. These are going to Oregon. Enjoy your pants. I hope they make your butt look fabulous. So I was watching my friend Keegan do a shipping video. He is the teen reseller. Wow. You've got to admire somebody who's running a better than my business, that's for sure, while still going to school and being a kid. But I think he's not senior this year. Anyway, he finally got a tape dispenser. I'm so excited because it was driving me insane watching him tear off pieces of tape. He doesn't put his stuff in clear bags. He folds it up in nice packing paper. Incoming. What's next? Oh, this is a little older. See, I've got these all arranged now like I'm a dealer in Vegas. This is a linen top from a brand called Naldi. Naldi Valentina. Valentina Naldi? That sounds more likely. Put up a picture, Heidi. I've had these since May. I got them at Goodwill. And I sold it for $20. Net profit $11.77. That is also on eBay. It's very pretty. I'm glad it sold before summer ended and made it impossible to sell. But it had eyelet lace and it was just a very feminine, pretty top. I hope you enjoy that. Also, Oregon, what's going on? Is everybody in Oregon talking about, hey, you gotta shop Heidi's store? Heidi's got the goods. This is the label for that package. What do I do? I guess I put it over there. I'm fine. I really am fine. I just can't talk and ship at the same time. This was disappointing, I guess, but So you've heard of Liberty or Liberty of London Fabrics. They make beautiful cotton fabrics and they're known for their wonderful prints. This brand of shirt is Contemporane and it is a house brand of the Simons retailer, which I think is a Canadian department store. Anyway, I think that affected the value of the shirt if it had been, you know, Gucci. That's a bad example. If it had been a better known American brand, probably I would have done better with it. But it was a cute button front shirt that I sold for $21.15. I paid $3.74 for it in June. My net after everything, $11.47. So very bread and buttery. But for a Liberty print, I was hoping for better. I guess I could have waited longer, but when 2 months goes by, you kind of think, let's sell that sucker. I would love to know what you think is fast. That's a question I'd love to ask other resellers. What is fast selling to you or slow selling? I wish that I was McThrifty because when sometimes she'll say, yeah, and I accepted this offer because, you know, I'd had it for a month. I'd be like, wow, it's only been a month and I sold that already. She just sells things fast. She buys better stuff. She's so great. I really enjoy watching her hauls and her what sold or ship with me. This, I chalk this up to the power of relisting. I've had this Levi's shirt since January of 21. It's a men's button front shirt with a hood, but I thought the plaid was cute. It looked very beachy and vacationy. And I've been going in and sorting by my oldest stuff in eBay and then relisting those if they haven't been relisted lately. And I relisted this last week and I sold it for $15 over the weekend. Net after all, $9.49. I don't buy Levi's fashion anymore. Once in a while, I buy Levi's jeans. That's my Levi's story. But I don't buy their shirts. Even denim is hard to move. Denim shirts. Pearl snaps don't get much. You can sell them, but they don't get much. So Levi's, other than denim, not a fan. What do you think? Now, I think these are all Poshmark. Let's make sure so I don't put things in the wrong package. Boom, boom, boom. Super. What's next in my grab bag of goodies? Oh, I was happy with this. This is a Madewell rib knit top. Kind of. Hi, kids. I'm breaking in here to correct myself. This was not a Madewell top, it was a Maeve top by Anthropologie. Still cute, still a good price, but not Madewell. Cute, light color, but heavier for fall. But so if you look at the, honestly, if you look at trending fashion for fall 23, you can find anything you want. You can find sites that say animal prints are out or others are in or only a little, not all a lot, and red, not red, brick red, bright red, blush red, pink, orange. But a lot of them, and I don't look at runway shows. My customers are not buying runway clothes. I'm more looking at what's on the main pages of department stores or Anthropologie or trendy websites. What are they selling this fall? What did they decide 18 months ago they were going to be selling now? I see a lot of neutrals. A lot of neutrals. A lot of. So I'm putting capsule wardrobe, minimalist, neutral in my descriptions in case somebody's shopping for, they only want gray, black, brown, beige, and they're maybe, ooh, let's go crazy and do navy. I'm seeing a lot of mixed neutrals, so people can have fewer pieces and wear them with more things. This kind of shirt falls into that category. It's got a little bit of style, but not, it's not something you would say, didn't you wear that 2 weeks ago? You know, those people at the office that keep track of what you wear. So Madewell Ivory Top, I got it in June for $3.62 at Goodwill, sold for $25. That's excellent for a Madewell top, am I right? And my net after L was $16.38. Going to Alabama. Thank you very much, Alabama. I hope you enjoy your Madewell top. I'm trying to be very quiet for those of you that are sensitive to that kind of noise. Or you wear earbuds, right? Crinkle, crinkle. That's gotta drive you crazy. So this Crane swimming suit I will put up. I would never buy Crane. I'm not recommending it. But it was, I found it one day when all the swim in this particular store was $2.99. And it was new with tags and it was a whole swimming suit. And I'll admit it, I was going a little crazy. But I did sell it. I bought it in June for $2.99, sold it for $17. Net after all, $10.64. If I can make $10, I'm winning. Naturally, I'd rather make $30 or $40. This is going to Michigan. Thank you. I would really rather make a lot of profit, but you can only sell what you can find. And I am selling the best stuff around me. That is a cute suit. Boom. I know I'm kind of quiet today. I'm on my second cup of coffee. Still, can't get revved up. You like my new picture? Do you remember when I showed you that Portland Saturday Market poster? Haven't sold it yet. It's all rolled up in a tube over there, ready to ship if I do sell it. But when I took it out of this cheap frame, it's just those black things that slide off. When I took it out of the cheap frame, underneath I found a Monet print poster, and I like it. I like colorful art. Doesn't have to be famous, but I like colorful art, and it's hiding something ugly behind it. What's this? Oh, yes, this was a great one. 53, 69. This is a Land's End dress in a navy. Hi kids, I'm breaking in again to correct myself. Not only is it not a dress and not a swimsuit, it is a swim top, a tankini top. Great price for that. Blue stripe, very cute. This was the day I found a whole bunch of dresses at Salvation Army in June. Paid $1.99. Yes, I did. Sold it for $30. So the fees were six. My net after everything was $22.01. I'm very happy with that. Land's End, I usually only get, oh wait, this is not a dress. It's a swimming suit. I was gonna say I only buy swim in Land's End, and that's exactly what I did. So a swimming suit for $30, can you believe it? Okay, let's edit all of this. So this next item is a Land's End swimming suit, which I got in June at Salvation Army for $1.99. It's very cute, nautical stripe. But the best part is it sold for $30, full price on Poshmark. I listed it high. Usually I list my tankinis at $24.99 and expect to sell them between 11 and 21. I'm sorry, not 11, 15 and 21. I like 18. That's a good number to sell things at. But suits I usually list at like $29.99 or $30. And this one sold on Poshmark for full price. So, going to Minnesota. Hello, Minnesota. I was born in Minneapolis. Did you know that? Why did you know that? So, Land's End is one of my favorite swim brands. L.L. Bean is another, Miracle Suit is another. But as I said, I marked down all my swim prices this weekend. I'm going to do something similar on Poshmark today. Because I'd really like to only have half a dozen pieces, and I have about 25. Oh, I just sold something. Oh, a skirt. I just relisted that 2 days ago as well. I love relisting. Next, what is next? Oh, this was great. This was a good sale. I got this in June in a men's thread up box. It's a Patagonia men's button up shirt, probably organic cotton, a really pretty plaid. I sold that for full price on Poshmark for $37. Paid $350, that was the price per item in that box. Net $26.10. Lovely. That, I think selling things for $35 or $40 is gonna be my goal. Because then I always make $25 or $30, which is a good thing to make. So enjoy your shirt in Nevada. Boom. We're getting down there, in case you're getting bored. The end is coming. 56.30. Oh, this sold quickly, in a week. Outdoor Voices or Outdoor Research? Which? I think it was Outdoor Voices. I found the exact style name for this, some sort of cloud knit or something like that. It's a green space dye or heathered hoodie in a very soft knit. That's probably why they called it cloud. I got it at Goodwill for, I don't know how much. Oh, looks like about $350. Sold it for $28 in a week. Net after everything, $19.03. That was another good one, almost $20, can you imagine? Going to Massachusetts. My friend Lori Tater lives, except I think she's in Japan right now. How exciting would that be? How dreadful would that long plane flight be? Yeah, I've gotten so that I'm kind of princessy when it comes to airplanes. I'd like one of those whole compartments where you could lay down. Oh, that would be lovely. But it must cost as much as a small car. Three left. Here we go. Oh, I was very pleased with this. Poshmark just, what is it up with Poshmark anyway? So before I got Posh VA, which shares my closet, makes offers to likers all automatically, and then I can also use it to raise or lower prices, relist things. I can schedule that, but I just do it manually. It's fabulous. Before I got that, Poshmark was probably 5 to 10% of my sales, sometimes 20 if I really worked it, but no, a tiny percent. And I have about almost 400 listings on Poshmark, and I have almost about 650 on eBay, so not everything. But my history with Poshmark was I would list it both places and then delete it from Poshmark when it sold on eBay. But I got Posh VA at the February 1st. And since then, my Poshmark has been growing and growing and growing. Now, July dipped down a little because of the summer, and August won't be as much. But I've been selling between $9 and $1,200 a month on Poshmark, when I used to sell, I was lucky if I sold $200. So, but this weekend, 4 eBay sales and 9 Poshmark sales. That is, something's wrong on eBay. I've checked all my numbers. I have looked at, did they cancel my store subscription? My views are down, but not a lot. It's just my sales that are down. So what are these? These are Jade Jill pull-on elastic waist linen pants in kind of a spring green color. I'll put a better picture up. I got these at Goodwill in May for $4.72. Sold them for $34. I gave a shipping discount. And the net was $20.46. They're an extra large. I do like selling linen pants to people in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. I hope you enjoy them. that was a good, oh no, I think I just dropped a label. Which means I'm gonna have more editing to do. I'm back. What's in the bag? This is little. Yeah, this was a mistake. 3 weeks ago, I bought some Aerie leggings at Goodwill for $3.37. I see people picking up Aerie, but I don't know which ones. Once I comped them, I listed them for $15, and then Pasha VA sent out an offer. My offers are set. I don't send offers to likers within the first 2 days. And then I send a 15% offer. So if you like it, like after 3 or 4 days, you get an offer within 10 minutes. But if you like it like the first day, you don't get an offer. I just think some things need some time to sell full price first. Am I making a mistake? Should I send offers right away, even on day one? Discount the price right away? I don't know. What do you think? Please tell me what to do. So these sold for $12. $2.95 fee, $3.37 cost. Wait for it. This is only half a slice of bread with no butter. Profit, $5.68. Probably just about covered my time to list it. Going to Alaska. I hope you love them. Last item. Harley Davidson. This is a men's shirt. Short sleeve. But the graphic was very cool. Let me see if I can show you. This is embroidery, but it looks kind of raggedy, like it was done with a big marker. Do you know what I mean? Those giant big poster markers where somebody just wrote Harley Davidson. And this is all embroidery, but it's just really messy looking. Very cool. And then it had the big Harley logo on the back, and then the front just said Harley. So I will put up a picture. I've had that for a week. Listed it for $25 and sold for that. Cost was $3.37. My net after all, $16.63. Harley is pretty bread and butter. I mean, if you find leather items with Harley or Harley from, I have extra thank you. Some people didn't get a thank you sticker, so thank you. But they're special Harley pieces, collectible ones from certain places or certain events or, you know, things that are collectible for some reason, plus leather. But most of the shirts are a bread and butter kind of a deal. So that's my shipping. I do have to go find this package and put this label on it. And then I'm going to put it out for the mail person. Yeah, $331 in sales. $211 in profit. I'm happy with that. I'm not happy. I'm content. I'm satisfied. I'm okay. I'm okay with it. Thank you. How are you? How were your sales? Please leave a comment. Do a thumbs up. Maybe subscribe if you haven't. That would be helpful. Next time you come back, I'm going to have another thread up unboxing for you. It's either going to be 30 pounds of denim or 50 pounds of women's mixed clothing. Thread up recently had a 30% off sale on their boxes. And of course, all the good stuff was gone. Even all the men's was out of stock. I don't know how long it had been up there before I noticed it. But I got some denim very cheap. My last denim box was 50 pounds, 44 pieces. And I've sold quite a bit of that, and I donated a lot, and I took a lot to Plato's. So that one was worth it. And both of these will have a very cheap cost of goods. So if you like thread up unboxings, please come back. Turn on notifications so you don't miss it. Have a great week. Get out there and sell your stuff. Bye, kids.